Welcome to Schooling, CBSE Class 12, Economics Chapter 5, Rural Development, Part 1. I will be uploading Part 2 also shortly. Please watch both the videos. We are going to discuss about rural development. So what is rural development? It is a process of improving the quality of life and economic well-being of people living in rural areas. The concentration should not be only for the urban areas. Development should happen in rural areas too, because it is very important to improve the rural areas. It means an action plan for the social and economic upliftment of the rural areas. Rural development includes development of infrastructure, human capital formation, development of productive resources, poverty alleviation, land reforms, creating jobs and opportunities for the people. Key areas in rural development. Challenges: development of the productive resources of a particular area, development of human resources including female literacy, development of human resources like health, addressing both sanitation and public health. The key areas in rural development. Implementation of land reforms, infrastructure development like electricity, irrigation, credit, marketing, transport facilities, roads and feeder roads to nearby highways, facilities for agriculture research and extension and information dissemination, measures for alleviation of poverty with employment opportunities. The share of agriculture sector's contribution to GDP was on a decline. Rural credit. What is rural credit? It means providing loans to the farmers. Why do farmers have to obtain loans? Because there are more number of small and marginal farmers. They practice subsistence farming, that is, they use for their own usage, for their family needs. They don't sell it in the market. They don't have marketable surplus. Sowing and harvesting takes time to give benefits for them. Farmers have to borrow for productive borrowings and unproductive borrowings. Productive borrowings are getting loans to buy seeds, fertilizers, and agricultural equipment and implements. Unproductive borrowings are loans for marriages and festive occasions. Types of rural credit. Credit needs of farmers may be classified as long-term credit, medium-term credit, and short-term credit. Long-term credit. These are loans to acquire assets like tractors, land, costly equipment, tube wells, etc. The loan period is from 5 to 20 years. Medium-term credit. These are loans for purchasing machinery, constructing fences, and digging wells. The loan period is from 12 months to 5 years. Short-term credit. These are loans for buying seeds, tools, manure, and fertilizers, etc. This credit is given to the needy borrowers by cooperatives, moneylenders, and banks. The loan period is from 6 months to 12 months. Sources of rural credit. Credit in the rural sector is available from two sources: non-institutional source and institutional source. Non-institutional sources of rural credit are moneylenders, friends, relatives, landlords, shopkeepers, and commission agents. Moneylenders provided about 93.6% of the total financial requirement in rural areas. Non-institutional sources of credit are not encouraged by the government because of the following reasons. They charge high rate of interest, they acquire land on failure to pay interest and loan, they manipulate accounts. Kudumbashree, the Poor Women's Bank. Kudumbashree is women-oriented community-based poverty reduction program being implemented in Kerala. In 1995, a thrift and credit society was started as a small savings for poor women with an objective to encourage savings. The Thrift and Credit Society mobilized Rs 1 crore as thrift savings. These societies have been acclaimed as the largest informal banks in Asia in terms of participation and savings mobilized. Institutional sources of rural credit. Different institutions were formed to provide the rural credit. The major institutional sources of rural credit are as follows: National Development for Agriculture and Rural Development, NABARD. It was set up in 1982 as an apex body to coordinate the activities of all institutions involved in the rural financing system. NABARD. The main functions of NABARD: to grant long-term loans to the state government, to take the responsibility of inspecting cooperative banks and regional rural banks, RRBs, to promote research in agriculture and rural development, to serve as a refinancing agency for the institutions providing finance to rural and agricultural development, and to help tenant farmers and small farmers to consolidate their land holdings. Self-help groups or microcredit. Formal credit system is not sufficient. Self-help groups, there is no collateral requirement. Self-help groups promote thrift in small proportions by a minimum contribution from each member. Credit provisions are generally referred to as microcredit programs. SHGs have helped in the empowerment of women. Kisan Credit. Kisan Credit Card scheme was introduced by the government in 1998 and 1999. It facilitates access to credit from commercial banks and regional rural banks. The eligible farmers are provided with a Kisan card and passbook from the relevant bank. The farmers can make withdrawals and repayments of cash within the credit limit as specified in the Kisan credit card. Commercial banks and cooperatives. Commercial banks, they were included into the field of agricultural credit under the Banking Reforms Act 1972. Commercial banks disburse agricultural credit for the purchase of inputs, cattle, tractors, dairy farming, installation of tube wells, etc. Cooperative credit societies. The cooperative credit societies are actively engaged in addressing credit needs of the farmers. The main function of cooperative credit society is to provide timely and increased flow of credit to the farmers. Advantages of rural banking: raising farm and non-farm output, generating credit for self-employment schemes in rural areas, achieving food security as we have abundant buffer stocks of grains. Limitations of rural banking: small and marginal farmers receive only a very small portion of the institutional credit. Rural banks suffer from the problems of overdues and default rate. The sources are insufficient to meet the requirements of agricultural credit. There are regional inequalities. It is suggestible that more and more regional rural banks should be set up to meet the credit need of the rural and backward areas of India. End of part 1. We have come to the end of part 1. I hope you would have understood about this chapter. For more videos on social science, sociology and economics, please watch Schooling on YouTube. Like, share, comment and subscribe Schooling. Thank you.